With Intellect Plus, AMD recently introduced an answer to NVIDIA's Reflex feature. But why should you care? Well, we all want our games to feel responsive and smooth, and multiplayer games to have as little lag as possible. To achieve that, it's important to play at high frame rates, which is why we try to extract as many frames per second from our graphics card as possible. Now, for every frame the GPU renders, the CPU must first process the data sent by your mouse, keyboard, or controller. And for multiplayer games, it must also process the data you receive from the server. Then it has to simulate the game world and prepare the data the graphics card needs to render the next frame. Besides that, the CPU also has to deal with all the other processes and applications that are running in the background. So to get the highest frame rate possible, we need to max out our graphics card. To achieve that, our CPU must have the data for the next frame ready by the time the GPU finished rendering the current frame. We cannot have the graphics card wait for the CPU, as that will reduce the frame rate. So we just need to get a CPU that is fast enough to fully utilize our GPU and all is good, right? Well, sadly this creates a problem. Now our CPU prepares more frames per second than the graphics card is able to render, which means that the graphics card is now a bottleneck for the CPU. This render queue then creates back pressure in the game engine, which we feel as an increase in system latency, as all the processing of the input data, the server data, and the simulation of the game world takes place before the graphics card renders a frame. Simply put, a maxed out graphics card increases the delay between our input and the result showing up on the monitor. So, we don't want to be CPU limited, because we cannot get the highest frame rate out of our graphics card then. But we also don't want to be GPU limited, because that makes the game less responsive. So, how can we fix this? AMD and Nvidia first tried to address this issue on the driver level, with AMD anti-lag and Nvidia ultra-low latency. However, as I could show in many videos over the years, these features are frankly a waste of time. Turns out poking the game engine from the outside only results in marginal latency savings that do not have a noticeable impact on our gaming experience. Nvidia eventually changed how they approached this issue, and with Reflex they provided a solution that fixed the problem right where it occurs, inside the game engine. This is why Reflex can cut the system latency in half in many games. Now, how about AMD's new Anti-Lag Plus? Well, there is much to talk about, but first, how did I test it? For the monitor, I used the 360Hz 1440p ASUS PG27AQN. And while the PC is not the latest and greatest, it is still capable of maxing out the graphics cards. Now, to avoid problems with the GPU drivers when switching between AMD and Nvidia, I decided to simply do a clean install of Windows 11 23H2 on two separate 1TB M.2 SSDs from Samsung. So I had one SSD with the clean Windows install and the AMD drivers for the RX 7600, and another with the clean Windows install and the Nvidia drivers for the RTX 4060 Ti. To measure the delay that you are affected by when playing a game, I have to test the entire end-to-end latency of a system. For that, I use the Display Latency Analyzer tool, and I always run its software on a separate PC because it's easier to use and avoids that the software affects the PC I am testing on. Besides that, this approach also puts some viewers' concerns at ease, because that way the software has no idea which GPU I test or what game I use. I do not use AMD's system lag or other system latency overlays because these do not tell the full story and in some cases are even misleading. So let's see some results already. In Fortnite I measured an average system latency of 41.3 milliseconds at 126 frames per second with the RX 7600 maxed out. Setting the in-game frame rate limiter to 120 FPS reduced the system latency significantly. For the next test, I disabled the frame rate limiter and enabled Anti-Lag Plus in the Adrenaline software. This resulted in about the same latency reduction as with the in-game frame rate limiter, while the frame rate was reduced by just 2 FPS. With the RTX 4060 Ti maxed out, I measured an average system latency of 40.05 milliseconds at 132 FPS. With the in-game frame rate limiter set to 120, the system latency was reduced significantly. Then, with the in-game frame rate limiter disabled and NVIDIA's Reflex set to on in the video settings of Fortnite, we also see a massive system latency reduction while we lost just 1 FPS. So, I can already see some of you hitting the comment section asking, if I just need to enable the in-game frame rate limiter to cut the system latency in half, then why do we even need Anti-Lag Plus or Reflex? Well, not every game comes with a built-in frame rate limiter, and those which do might just allow you to choose from a few presets, which can reduce your frame rate significantly. But more importantly, the frame rate limit that you set inside the game is static. If your PC cannot always maintain that frame rate, then your graphics card will get maxed out occasionally. And when that happens, you will experience a sudden spike in system latency. Simply put, you can think of both Anti-Lag Plus and Reflex as dynamic frame rate limiters, which constantly adjust the frame rate limit to operate your graphics card on the razor's edge of almost being maxed out. This is how you can maximize the frame rate while at the same time avoiding that system latency bump that occurs when the graphics card gets maxed out, which makes it the perfect solution to our problem. Next, let's look at Overwatch 2. Without a frame rate limit, I measured an average system latency of 50.75 milliseconds at 131 FPS with the RX 7600 maxed out. With the in-game frame rate limiter set to 6 frames below the maximum, the system latency was cut in half. Anti-Lag Plus reduces the system latency significantly, but it gets beaten by the in-game frame rate limiter. However, as I mentioned before, using a static frame rate limit has its downsides, and further optimization by AMD could improve this result. When we then look at the results from the RTX 4060 Ti, we also see a 50% reduction with the in-game frame rate limiter. And with NVIDIA's Reflex, we get the same latency reduction while losing just 1 FPS. Next is Apex Legends. With the RX 7600 maxed out, I measured 32.41 milliseconds on average at 140 FPS. With the frame rate limiter set to 134 by using the FPS max startup parameter, the system latency was reduced by 1/3. A result that Anti-Lag Plus is sadly not able to achieve. With the RTX 4060 Ti, we see Reflex again perform as well as the in-game frame rate limiter, which is exactly what we want to see. Then there's Counter-Strike 2. Currently, it is not possible to use Anti-Lag Plus with this game, because Valve blocked the driver, and so you cannot even launch the game. More on that in a minute. The results of the RTX 4060 Ti are interesting, because Reflex reduces the system latency more than the in-game frame rate limiter. I have done additional tests with other NVIDIA GPUs and on a different PC, where I have seen the exact same behavior. So this shows that Reflex and potentially Anti-Lag Plus can outperform an in-game frame rate limiter. Now let's compare Anti-Lag Plus and Reflex. When it comes to the hardware requirements, you need an RX 7000 series graphics card. So you have to buy a new graphics card if you want to use this feature, and AMD did not explain why they cannot support older cards. To me, this requirement seems very strange, considering that Reflex works with any NVIDIA GPU that has been released since 2014. But not just their hardware requirements differ greatly, the way how they integrate into the game does too. Support for Anti-Lag Plus is added by AMD, not the game developer. AMD does that by injecting their code into the game engine and detouring DLL functions. NVIDIA, on the other hand, provides a software development kit that game developers can use to add support for Reflex directly to their game, where NVIDIA also provides support with the integration and optimization. Now, what are the risks of using either of these features? The way how AMD decided to inject Anti-Lag Plus into the game is basically the same as hacks or cheat software attack a game, which not just might trigger anti-cheat protection, it instantly did trigger anti-cheat and got players banned. This is why Valve blacklisted this driver and why AMD quickly released a new driver where they disabled Anti-Lag Plus entirely, and it is still disabled in the current driver at the time that I make this video. As far as I know, this patch note is the only official statement from AMD about this incident. I couldn't find any other communication from AMD, like an apology for getting players banned. At the time of making this video, I also don't know if all players who got banned for enabling Intellect Plus got their ban lifted or not. Reflex, on the other hand, is implemented by the game developer, so there is no risk to have it trigger anti-cheat protection. Now, what are the pros of Intellect Plus over Reflex? AMD can add support for any game they like, as they don't have to involve the game developer. AMD just has to spend the time and resources to find out where to inject their code into the game, and then rigorously test their integration to make sure that they inject at the right place. With Reflex, we get a very clean integration into the game engine and the game's options menu. Reflex is also optimized by the game developer and Nvidia to make sure that you get the highest possible latency saving in every game that supports it. Another huge benefit is that Reflex is supported by any Nvidia GPU released since 2014. And if you use Reflex together with a G-Sync monitor, then you don't have to manually cap the frame rate below the maximum refresh rate of the monitor. Reflex takes care of that. If you want to know more about that, then you can find a link to my setup tutorial in the description. Now, what downsides does Intellect Plus have? Injecting Intellect Plus into the game does not only create the risk of getting banned. Game updates can also degrade or even break Intellect Plus support, depending on what the game developer changed. Then there's the barrier to entry, as you need the latest RDNA 3 GPU to use Intellect Plus, which makes absolutely no sense to me. And AMD did not explain why the requirement is that high. Performance-wise, there is inconsistency between games, but that could be improved with further optimization. The first-time activation of Intellect Plus inside the Adrenaline software requires a restart of the entire game for Intellect Plus to work. And if you own a FreeSync monitor, then you must still use a frame rate limiter, as Intellect Plus does not keep the frame rate inside the variable refresh rate range of the monitor. Pretty much the only downside of Reflex when compared to Intellect Plus is that only the game developer can add support for this feature. However, considering the risks and problems of AMD's approach, I'm not sure if that is even a downside. So here's what I do not understand. Why did it not occur to AMD that making Intellect Plus behave like a hack is a problem? And why did they not talk to the game developers before they enabled Intellect Plus for their multiplayer games? AMD is already working with game developers to optimize their games for their GPUs and implement their FSR upscaling technology. So why did they decide to hack their way into the game to get Intellect Plus supported instead of working with the game developer? Surely it isn't more work to help the game developer implement your latency mitigation feature properly than trying to figure out on your own where to inject your feature into the game, test the integration, then keep fixing it when a game update breaks the integration, and also work with anti-cheat solution providers to not have them ban players for using Intellect Plus. In fact, in 2021 I talked to an engineer from AMD about Intellect and how it gets beaten by a simple in-game framerate limiter. I did suggest that for the Intellect successor, they should work with game developers to get that feature integrated and optimized. But back then I already felt that there was no interest in that, which I found disappointing. So for those of you who invested in an AMD GPU, I just hope that the Counter-Strike 2 bans were enough to wake up AMD. They must lower the quite frankly silly hardware requirements of Intellect Plus, provide game developers with a software development kit, and work with them to integrate it properly, as they have done and are still doing for other AMD exclusive features. And that's it for today. So until next time, have a nice day and take care. My name is Chris, and this was Battle Nonsense.